Hello friends, myself Professor Narendra Katikar, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to present a topic on blow molding. The blow molding topic, at the end of this session, students will be able to understand the process as well as the application of plastic blow molding process. The content for this presentation, the flow will be like this: introduction, plastic blow molding process, polymers commonly used for blow molding, advantages of the blow molding process, disadvantages of the blow molding process, and applications for the blow molding process. Now in this presentation we'll see one of the particularly plastic part manufacturing process, that is blow molding process. Now in the introduction, let us see the important points: plastic material, need of plastic material products, plastic part manufacturing. As you know, the plastic material, the importance of the same is increasing day by day due to its whatever the number of advantageous properties over the other material. For many of the technical as well as the domestic products, now the material has been replaced through the means of plastic and subtype of plastics. This need of plastic material products is increasing to fulfill the current environmental conditions as well as through the means of optimized costings. The very important property for the plastic is the easily moldable, and it can be recycled in many sense. In consideration with the less weight as well as many other properties like major important optical property, thorough transparent to thorough opaque kind of properties delivers the extendedly use of plastic in the particularly many of the plastic part manufacturing. Now when we discuss the plastic part manufacturing, as per the design, shape, geometry, quantity and cost, the very number of plastic part manufacturing processes are defined. Out of that, considering the above features, we have to select one of the process. Now in this presentation, let us see the one of the important plastic part manufacturing through the means of plastic blow molding process. Plastic blow molding process is normally is going to be used to produce the hollow parts. Now in the three steps, we can see over here how the blow molding process goes. In the step 1, you can observe that the red part plastic raw material is present in the form of stick. It is called as the Parisian stick. The mold halves are normally divided into two parts. The Parisian stick is inserted into the mold cavity. Now the melted polymer material is injected between the two closed half of the mold in the step 1. Normally, the natural air or a particular waste gas is going to be inserted to the Parisian stick through the means of high pressure nozzles. Now, in the step 2, you can observe the particular Parisian stick raw material is tried to be expanded, and it is going to be adhere the internal mold surfaces wall. Now the expansion can be restricted through the means of molding walls. Obviously, the calculation of gas to be fed into the Parisian stick rather the mold is calculated. All the parameters of gas flows are calculated. The Parisian stick volume is equivalent as that of the particular part to be produced, etc. Now in the step 2, As you can see, the air enters the cavity and pushes the polymer into the shape of the mold. In the third stage, you can see that the Parisian stick is fully now expanded and got the shape of inner wall surface of the cavity. Further, it has been cooled down for a very few seconds. Further, immediately the mold's halves are moved out from their original position, and the completed solidified plastic part will be get fall down. Now, in these three stages, you can imagine that particular parts can be produced in a very easy way with the means of blow molding. Now, the further one more imagination, one more slide for imagination has been inserted. This is the plastic PET bottle used for oil storing purpose. You can see that blue Parisian stick is there in the first stage of diagram. Now that Parisian stick is inserted into the die cavity. In the second stage, you can see that the air is trying to be inserted into the Parisian stick. In the third, fourth stage, you can observe that the Parisian stick is trying to be bulged, and in a bulging stage, the diagram shows that the material is trying to cover up uniformly the walls, rather the inner walls of the mold. In the last and second last stage, you can observe that almost the inner wall geometry is accommodated by the plastic raw material itself. In the last diagram, you can observe that thoroughly the plastic bottle is ready. Normally, the polymers used for blow molding processes are polyamide, polyethylene, and so many others. Advantages of blow molding: as it is a very fast production, low cost in mass production, material and color flexibility delivers the extendedly use of blow molding. The low labor cost and low waste will also improve the efficiency of the blow molding. It has some certain limitations: high initial tooling cost, high initial setup cost, and these are the only use for hollow part designs. Now, my dear friends, application of blow molding. At this stage of this session, are you able to share some of the day-to-day application of plastic blow molding process? Try to enlist the same. Yes, now, but I will share you some of the application of blow molding. The water and medicine bottles, PET bottles, decorative hollow parts, and storage containers. These are the some of the applications of blow molding. I suppose that you had learned the particularly all the details of blow molding in a technical sense. The applications which I shared with you, those are technical as well as domestic purpose. References for this presentation: NPTEL's website, Wikipedia, as well as Modern Plastic Handbook. Thank you.